As the question says, in the given circuit, the internal resistance of the 18 volt cell is negligible. If R1 is 400, R3 is 100 and R4 is 500, and the reading of an ideal voltmeter across R4, that I've written it as V4, is 5 volt, then the value of R2 will be. Yes guys, we are supposed to find the value of R2. So first thing, let name the voltage across all the four resistances as V1, V2, V3 and V4. And similarly, the current passing through all the resistances as I1, I2, I3 and I4. So our the naming is quite clear. Okay. Now, can I say, since we know the value of V4 and R4, we can actually find the current through the resistance 4. And that will be V4 is equal to I4 into R4. So V4 is 5, R4 is 500. So we can say I4 is 1 by 100 ampere or 10 milliampere. Now definitely, since R3 and R4 are in series, we can say I4 will also be equal to I3. Means the same current will flow through both the resistances. Now, we know over here in this branch, we are getting the current of 10 milliampere. Okay? So can I say, we can find the potential difference across both the resistance as 1, and can say the resistance across V3 plus V4, we will get the resistor voltage across R2. So can I have V3 plus V4 as I into R3 plus I into R4. So if you notice, I can write this as I3 and I4, but they both are equal. So if I place that, this is going to be 10 milliampere common. R3 is given as 100 and R4 is 500. So 100 plus 500 is 600. That makes the value of V2, that is the potential difference across R2 or the combination of R3 and R4, since they are in parallel, we can say that is going to be 6 volt. So the voltage across this is 6 volt. Now can I say that total voltage for the circuit is 18 volt, which is divided between 1 and the combination of 2, 3 and 4, which is same for 2 because they are in parallel. So we can say the EMF is actually equal to V1 plus V2. So EMF is 18, V1 is unknown, V2 we just found as 6. And so V1 we will get it as 12 volt. So the voltage across R1 is already known now. Now can I find the current passing through R1 as I1 is equal to V1 by R1. So V1 we know as 12 volt and R1 we know as 400. So 12 by 400 is as good as 3 by 100. And 3 by 100 is nothing but 3 or 30 milliampere. Yes guys, that means the current over here is 30 milliampere. So now if you check, out of 30 milliampere, 10 milliampere is going on the upper branch. So definitely through this branch, the I2 will be 20 milliampere, definitely using Kirchhoff's current law. Now if you notice, we already know the value of the current through the resistance R2, and we also know the value of the potential difference across R2. So definitely we can find the value of R2 using Ohm's law as R2 is equal to V2 upon I2, where V2 the value is 6 upon I2 is 20 milliampere. So 20 into 10 raised to minus 3, that's equivalent to 6, or I should write it over here as 6000 by 20, which is nothing but 300 ohm as your final answer.